Praise the Lord, a pleasant good night and greetings in the precious and wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Special welcome to our online viewers tonight. Welcome to TWEC All Year's Night Service. You know, the norm would be, or the common thing that would be said, it's been quite a year. But we give God thanks nonetheless that we have made it thus far. We give God thanks because He is the one who has kept us. He is the one who has seen us through, and we know He's going to continue to be with us. Tonight we want to, as we seek to begin our service, we want to open in a word of prayer. Could you bow your heads with me at this time? Father, we give you thanks tonight. We thank you to be in the land of the living. We thank you, O God, for taking us through the hard and difficult times, dear Father. We thank you for your blessings, your provision for our lives, dear God. We thank you for your giving us this opportunity, O God, whereby we can worship, whereby, O God, we can be strengthened through your precious word. We commit tonight's service into your hands, O God. We pray for the leading of your Spirit, Father. We pray, God, for your fresh anointing upon your servants tonight, O God. We pray that you will just have your way, O God, that you will speak to us, God, and give us direction even into the new year, Father. Take complete control and charge over every aspect of the service. As we commit it into your hands tonight, Father, we give you thanks and praise in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Bless the name of the Lord. We want to go straight into our time of worship, and we want to welcome at this time Deacon Paul and his family, who is going to take us into our time of worship. Praise his holy name.
You
Thank you, Deacon Paul and family, for that wonderful time of worship. I trust that you were engaged in the time of worship, and it was truly a blessing. Praise the Lord. We thank God for the privilege to be able to worship him, because he deserves our worship. Bless his holy and wonderful name. Moving on with our service tonight, we want to welcome at this time Pastor Stephanie Edwards, who would come and bring to us our scripture reading tonight. Praise the Lord. God bless her as she comes.
Bless the Lord. Good night and greetings in Jesus' wonderful name. Tonight, I will be reading from Colossians chapter 3. Praise the Lord. Reading from the King James Version, it says, "If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil conspicuous, and covetousness, which is idolatry. For which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience, in the which ye also walk some time, when ye lived in them. But now ye also put off all these: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds, and have put on the new man, which ye is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. Where there is neither Greek nor Jews, circumcision nor uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, bond, free, but Christ is in all and in all. But on therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, bowel of mercies, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another, and forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgive you, so also do ye. Above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness, and let the peace of God rule in your heart, to the which also ye are called in one body. And be ye thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your heart to the Lord. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands, as it is fit in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives, and be not bitter against them. Children, obey your parents in all things, for this is well-pleasing unto the Lord. Fathers, provoke not your children to anger, lest they be discouraged. Servants, obey in all things your masters according to the flesh, not with eye pleasers, as men pleasers, but in singleness of heart, fearing God. And whatsoever ye do, do it heartily, as to the Lord, and not unto men, knowing that of the Lord ye shall receive the reward of the inheritance, for ye serve the Lord Christ. But he that doeth wrong shall receive for the wrong which he had done, and there is no respect of persons. May God add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his words.
Thank you, Pastor Stephanie. Praise his holy name. We thank God for his precious word tonight. Bless his holy and wonderful name. And as we continue with the program tonight, we want to welcome at this time Brother Michael Ramdas, who would minister to us in song at this time. We know that God is going to use him to minister to our hearts. Receive the time of ministry, Brother Michael, at this time.
Praise the Lord. It's good to be here tonight. Amen. You know, in John chapter 7, verse 38, he says, 37 and 38, he says, "He that believeth on me, as the scripture hath said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But he spake of the Spirit which he had believed on, when they that believed on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given." Hallelujah. You know, this scripture is talking about the river. You know, the rivers of living water that's flowing. And it refers to the Holy Spirit of God. The song I'm going to sing for you tonight, it's called River. Amen. And I want to encourage you all that you all, you know, that we be like, rivers are usually like the source of strength or a source of life for people. You know, and that's what I want to encourage you all in this coming year, you know, to be a source of life to the people who you are around, you know, that they would come to you, you know, because the whole world right now is becoming like a desert, you know, it's drying up spiritually. Every year that goes by, we get spiritually worse, you know, in the world. And we as Christians, you know, we are to be that source of strength, that source of life. Just like a river. Most civilizations have been built around rivers where there is a source of life. Amen. So we are, as we go out in the world, to be a source of life to people around, a source of hope. And once we live our lives according to the word of God and exemplify Christ, well, those who are looking for life will be drawn to us. Amen. So I pray as I sing it, your heart will be blessed and encouraged. Amen. Hallelujah.
Running free, let your waters flow through me. Reach beyond where I can see. Quench some thirsty soul in need, river, river. I have lived in the desert, and I have dwelt in a barren land. Once I built my life upon the shifting sand. I had no firm foundation, had no shelter to cover me. There was a little hope that I could see. Then I looked across this thirsty land, felt the heat of the burning sand. Didn't think that I could live another day. But what seemed a hopeless thing turned into a desert spring, and its waters washed my hopelessness away. Oh, river, running free. Let your waters flow through me. Reach beyond where I can see. When some thirsty soul in need, river, river, and oh, river, flow through me, and touch every soul I see. Running free, let your waters flow through me. Reach beyond where I can see. When some thirsty soul in need, river, river.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Brother Michael, for that wonderful song. Praise the Lord. Bless his holy and wonderful name. May you be challenged to be that blessing in the lives of others in this new year, in the new year to come. Praise his name. At this time, we want to have special greetings. It's going to be via video. And we're going to have special greetings at this time from the Bishop, Reverend Victor and Rita Maharaj. Praise his holy name. We want to receive them tonight. Hallelujah. God bless.
To all the saints of True Worshippers, Evangelistic Center, Coryell, Valencia, Borneo West, and Manstreet, I want to wish you all a wonderful new year and trust in God to give us victory in 2021. We had a wonderful 2020, and we know that the COVID, of course, touched a lot of people in the island. But thank God that He protects us from all the elements of evil and the evil sickness and disease and infirmities. And tonight I want to say, thank God for victory. Thank God for victory. And I want to wish all of you a wonderful 2021, and looking forward to see you all coming out by the numbers come Sunday morning service. Amen. So God bless all of you, and thanks to the pastors and all the leaders in the assemblies. God bless you all. Have a wonderful night in Jesus' name.
Greetings, brethren, in the wonderful name of our precious Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Oh, we thank God for all of your precious brethren, and even all our viewers who have been viewing the program during the past months. We thank God for all of you and your commitment also to the work of the Lord. Today, we count it a great privilege to be here, to be able to greet you all, thanking God, you know, for the past year thus far as we come to the end of 2020. And as we are about to enter the new year, 2021, we are trusting God, the God who brought us through 2020 and kept us and our families is the same God. And we know that He is more than able to keep us through 2021 and beyond. So God bless you all. We love you all. Do continue to fight the good fight of faith in Jesus' almighty name. Stay strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Amen. We wish you all God's richest blessings in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen. God bless you all. Love you.
Praise the Lord. We thank the bishops for that wonderful greetings tonight. Praise the Lord. As we continue with tonight's program, we want to welcome at this time Sister Liana Maharaj to minister to our hearts in song. Open your hearts and receive what the Lord has in store for you tonight. Praise his name.
As a good night to all the saints, I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You know, as we celebrate this season, we thank God for Jesus and for his birth and the incarnation, that he came down to be with us and to die for our sins. So, you know, as we go into the new year, we anxiously wait his return. So I pray that this song will be a blessing to your hearts.
Oh,
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Sister Leanna, for that wonderful song. I know that your heart has been blessed through the ministry of the song tonight. Praise his name. As we continue with tonight's service, we move into a special time, and that is the time of the ministry of the word. We know that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. So we want to welcome at this time the man of God who is going to bring the word of God to minister to our hearts. Just open and receive what God is saying tonight by his spirit. I want to welcome at this time Reverend Lincoln Maharaj, who is going to bring to us the word of God tonight. Praise his name. God bless.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The Lord is good, and his mercies endure it forever. Amen. It's a joy and a privilege to be alive, to be able to welcome in the new year. Amen. We thank God for his favor and his blessing towards us, his children, today. Tonight I want to read from the book of Judges. And of course, even as you would share, we're considering the end of 2020. And we look forward to what God has in store for us for 2021. Amen. We are looking tonight at the book of Judges, Judges chapter 6 and 7. So several scriptures will be coming from these two chapters as we consider the events in the life of Gideon. Amen. We want to pray for a little while. Father, we bless you. We give you thanks for everything that was said and done tonight, dear God. We thank you for your divine favor upon our lives that you have brought us through 2020. Many things happened that we were not expecting, dear God, but you remained faithful in the midst of it all. And for that, we give you praise, honor, and glory. We thank you for everything that was done thus far in this service. And even as we have come to your word, I pray that you will touch every heart and every mind that's paying attention, that's listening tonight. We ask, O God, that hearts will be encouraged and blessed. I claim your divine strength and leading by your Holy Spirit today. Speak to us all, we ask, in Jesus' wonderful and precious name. Praise God, amen and amen. I want to share with us for a little while tonight on the subject, learning to trust God in uncertain times. Learning to trust God in uncertain times. And I'm grateful for some of the work of our Lloyd Steele tonight. Praise God. Tonight, as we prepare to go into 2021, I believe that everyone desires a word from God about 2021. We are encouraged to plan and to prepare for the new year, and nothing is wrong with that. But you know, Pastor Laura, I remember vividly being in some meetings during the latter part of 2019. And we were planning for some national events that call for the participation of all the churches in Trinidad and Tobago, believing that we were in the will of God, even in the midst of the planning. Of course, at True Worshippers Evangelistic Center, we also had plans, and many of them had to be postponed. Amen. So, yes, tonight I'm saying that I'm going to be cautious. Many of the prominent international prophets, Pastor Joe, in light of recent events, are silent. They are silent. Even though people are calling and requesting a word for 2021. So I will not attempt to predict the future by way of promises and multiplied finances and promotions and expansions of borders, although at the moment our borders are closed. So people can go ahead and criticize and get down on me for not trusting in the Lord as they might feel. But I believe tonight that there are valuable lessons to be learned where we can trust in God in this unusual season. God has been with us, so we will trust him till the end of 2020 and we will trust him all through 2021. Amen. So even as you listen to the word of the Lord tonight, please don't expect any special predictions for 2021. As we consider the scripture tonight, we focus on Gideon, who was a regular citizen. He is not very impressive at first to look at, but he makes some choices that flow from his faith in God. So I'm saying tonight that there are some lessons here to help us learn how to trust God for this new year that is ahead. I will try not to be long, because after all, this is the last day of the year. Amen. So as we consider tonight, Judges chapter 6, from verse 1 to 6, we realize that as you would read these verses, we find that the nation of Israel, they are coming off of a time of relative ease. The bills have been paid. Business seemed to be good at the moment. Everything seemed to be going fine, seemed to be going nice. And I've realized that that this same thing happens in our own lives at times. But as we consider Israel during this time in Judges chapter 6, we realize that when things started to go good for them, they started to forget God. They became self-sufficient. They didn't need God. So the Lord decided to shake things up a little bit by causing an enemy to come up against them to show them how difficult life could be without God. And so in verse 1, it says that the Israelites did what was evil in the sight of the Lord. So the Lord handed them over to Midian for 7 years. Of course, we know that the Midianites were extremely powerful and they oppressed the Israelites mercilessly. Every year around the harvest time, the nomadic Midianites would come and they would invade Israel. Verse 5 tells us that they would be like locusts ravaging the land. When they would carry out their acts, their cruel acts, they would destroy from a side. The Bible reports that it was so bad that the Israelites left their homes and they started to live in caves and they built strongholds, hiding places, fearing for their own lives. This went on for 7 years. And finally, the Israelites, the Bible says, cried out to the Lord for their help. Why did they wait so long to turn to the Lord? I can't say really, but one thing I can relate to, that it happens in our own lives. We wait until things become impossible for us, and then we try to cry out to God. It happens in our own nation, where people try everything else, and when they just cannot make, then they call on God. Verse 6 tells us that Israel became poverty-stricken because of Midian. And the Israelites cried to the Lord, my God. How many times have difficult circumstances come upon our own lives? We plan for ourselves and we do our own things instead of crying out to the Lord. We feel and we believe truly we could handle it for ourselves. But I want to encourage us tonight. Learn this lesson from Gideon. Every experience in life is a test. Every trial in the lives of the people of God is tailored to draw us closer to Almighty God. Do not become too discouraged by it, but see it as a test indeed that will draw you closer to God. Proverbs chapter 3, 11 and 12, it says, do not despise the Lord's instruction, my son, and do not loathe his discipline. For the Lord disciplines the one he loves, just as a father the son he delights in. He loves you too much to let you continue living the way that you are living. And so now he would realize that you cannot come back by yourself, and he would allow certain things to come your way. He designed it that way so you can come back to him. Whom the Lord loves, he chastens. Amen. So I'm saying tonight, the first lesson we want to learn, that sometimes God would use tough times to get our attention. Amen. And so the enemy will try and feel he is doing his thing in your life. But this is the first lesson. The tough times come to get our attention. Just maybe we have allowed the good things and the blessings to turn us away from God, feeling that everything is going to be all right. But whom the Lord loves, he chastens. Keep your focus on the Lord. From verse 7, we see the other lesson is this. God sees more than we do. The wonderful thing about God is that even though we are slow in returning to him, he is never slow in responding to us. Despite all the pressure that came to them, they faced it for so many years before they started to cry out to God. That's what verses 7 and 8 seem to tell us. It showed us that when we cry out to God, he moves in mercy and love towards us. He tells us the truth, and he begins to work behind the scene to help us in our difficult situation. For Israel, God first sends an unnamed prophet to call them back to total surrender and full devotion to God. But his plan also included a most unlikely man by the name of Gideon. So we meet Gideon, the Bible tells us in verse 11, and he is in a threshing floor, amen, threshing some wheat, but he's not doing this in the usual place on the outside where the wind and the breeze could blow the chaff away. No, because of the Midianites, he is now threshing this wheat in a wine press. Because he didn't want them to come and take everything away from him. It's a pitiful sight, but it happens because of frustration and discouragement and fear. He had to hide to do what he must do. So the Bible tells us in verse 12, then the angel of the Lord appeared to him and said, "The Lord is with you, mighty man of valor, mighty warrior." Amen. And I could just imagine, here is Gideon hiding, and of course while he is threshing the wheat and he hears the voice of the angel and he's looking around wondering, where is the mighty man of valor, not realizing that God was speaking to him. And you wonder if God was being sarcastic. But of course, I believe that God saw what he was going to make out of Gideon. It was time for Gideon to believe what God spoke into his life. One of the biggest lies we tell ourselves is that God only used special people. But you see, Gideon went on to explain that he was not special. Amen. Some people feel that, of course, if you are not a born-again child of God, well then God is not going to move and God can't do anything. I'm saying to you tonight, God is able to transform you, and yes, he is able to use you, and you can enjoy this born again experience. Amen. Of course, as children of the Most High God, we see God as our friend. We know that we are God's children. The Bible tells us we are justified. We have been freed from condemnation. The Bible says that we are adopted into the family of God and we are citizens of heaven. Praise God. We belong to God. So in as much as Gideon felt at one time that he was not special, The Bible tells us that God was now able to turn things around for him. We who are called of God, we who are born again and are children of God, God is still able to turn things around for us. We belong to him. Amen. And so the scripture tells us again that God now confirms his priorities with his presence. So after being called a mighty warrior, Gideon now questions God. He says, "Please, sir, if the Lord is with us, why has all this happened to us? And where are all the wonders that our fathers told us about?" His conclusion in his time of difficulty was that Almighty God had abandoned Israel. God had abandoned them. You see, they grew up hearing about the great works of Almighty God. And so the scriptures tell us tonight that Gideon reminded this angel of that. Where is God? Where are the miracles that we heard about? The Bible says that in verse 14, God spoke to him. And God said, "Go in the strength you have and deliver Israel from the power of Midian. Am I not sending you?" That's the question. God says, "Am I not sending you?" So Gideon still didn't get the point. He went ahead to talk about himself, that he was a nobody. Amen. He had an unimpressive resume, and he laid it out before the Lord. He said, "I am the weakest link in this clan, the youngest in my family. I don't have authority to call out the cavalry. I don't have any power." But God, the Bible tells us, confirms his priority with his divine presence. Gideon, maybe you are nothing in your own eyes. Gideon, maybe people around you consider you as nothing, but Gideon, I will be with you. That's what the Lord said to him. "You will strike Midian down as one man, but I will be with you." So Gideon is given an undeniable commission, told the remarkable results in advance, that you are going to be victorious. And we are reminded daily, in as much as we approach the new year, we cannot predict what is ahead. But I want to say to us tonight, as 2021 approaches, God knows the beginning and he also knows the end. He knows the end from the very beginning. So God told Gideon, "You are going to conquer them. You are going to defeat them as one man." Praise God. You see, he was told this remarkable result in advance, and he was promised a partnership with God that was going to bring victory to him and the people of Israel. The Bible says that after further confirmation of that fact, he realized that he was dealing with God himself. He was dealing with God. And so as the pieces began to fall together for him, he cries out to the Most High God, realizing now what I'm hearing from God. And in verse 22 he says, "Oh no, Lord God, I have seen the angel of the Lord face to face, and so great fear came upon him." His calling was affirmed by Almighty God. Gideon needed a personal encounter with God. God met him right where he was, giving him a sense of peace and purpose by his personal promised presence. So he realized all that I was told, it was God speaking to me. Gideon was ready for the first test. Are you ready for the tests that are ahead of you tonight? I encourage you that God will show up for you. Amen. We have the promise of His divine presence. The next lesson I want us to learn is this. Private faithfulness is a prerequisite to public usefulness. We see that from verse 25. Before Gideon can be used publicly, he must first clean up his own backyard. His family was breaking the first and second commandment. They had idols built to Baal on their property. So the first assignment from the Lord was to take his father's special 7-year-old bull and tear down the idols. And as you listen tonight, I want you to speak those words to yourself. Tear down the idols. Then Gideon was to sacrifice that prized bull using the wood that came from the destroyed idols. What's the point that we are getting from this tonight? If you want to learn to trust God, you must first set your house in order. Amen. If we are to receive our blessings from God, from trusting Him, we must set our house in order. Before God can use you mightily, He must be magnified in your own life. Before God can use you mightily, He must be magnified in your home. Private worship prepares us for public power from Almighty God. There are no shortcuts. There are no shortcuts. So is there anything that you have been holding on to tonight that you know God is not pleased with? Is there any sin that you are clinging to that there is a conviction and you know it's wrong but you're still holding on to it? I'm saying to you tonight, knock down your idols. Confess your sin. Deal with it and return in full obedience to Almighty God. 2020 is almost over. Get right with God. Believers, I appeal to you. If there are idols in your lives, break them down. Break them down. It's going to stir things up a bit when you begin to do that. People might not like it, but I want to say to you, God will honor those who honor Him. It happened to Gideon. Now, from the scripture, we understand that this bull seemed to be community breeding stock owned by Gideon's family. Verse 30 reports that the men of the city said to Joash, "Bring out your son. He must die." But Gideon's act had already changed things. The very act of pulling down the idols, the very act of making that sacrifice, started to affect change in his father. And so Joash awoke to the truth and stood up to the man. Verse 31 says, "Would you plead Baal's case for him? If he is a god, let him plead his own case." Suddenly, Gideon's father has a voice. He is now bold and he is now brave. Praise God. So I encourage you, by making that stand for God, it will indeed encourage others to stand up for the Lord, to stand up for what is truth. Praise God. Remember, private faithfulness is a prerequisite to public usefulness. As you show yourself faithful to God, God will use you in a tremendous way. Praise God. Fifthly, God is patient with our faith process. God is patient with our faith process. When we go to verse 33, it says the Midianites and their partners were getting ready to make their annual raid. My God. But instead of cringing and hiding in a cave, the Bible says, verse 34, the spirit of the Lord enveloped Gideon, and he blew the ram's horn, and the Abizrites rallied behind him. Gideon had taken a huge step of faith, praise God, in his private faithfulness to God. And now God's spirit was drawing people from far and wide to stand with him to attack their long enemies, the enemies that affected them for years, long-standing enemies. People are now getting bold and brave and standing up with a man of God. The Spirit of God was drawing people. The Bible says 32,000 men showed up and they were now ready to fight. I asked myself the question, where were they all the time? It took somebody to stand up for what is right, to make a sacrifice, to kick down an idol, and let the Spirit of God do the rest. Amen. We realize that after his encounter with Almighty God, even though he had been obedient in cleaning up his house, even though the Holy Spirit was empowering him, Gideon still had his doubts. He knows that God has promised to save Israel through him, but he was looking in the mirror and the reflection that he saw was a discouraging reflection. He was doubting. You see, self and doubt are faith killers. Self and doubt destroys faith. They come and they pull down your faith. Verses 36 and 37, Gideon says to the Lord, if you will deliver Israel by my hand, as you said, I will put a fleece of wool here on the threshing floor. If dew is only on the fleece and all around the ground is dry, I will know that you will deliver Israel by my strength. He just had an experience with Almighty God in the presence of God. God speaking to him, the angel of the Lord giving him direction. But of course, doubt has a way of bringing discouragement. I love how loving and tender and patient God is with us. Gideon is now making a deal with God. He wants a sign of confirmation. And the Bible tells us, of course, the next morning, God gave him his confirmation. The fleece was wet and the ground right around was dry. But like so many of us, after God has spoken into our lives, we don't want to accept what God said to us the first time. We want God to speak again. And so doubting Gideon, like doubting Thomas, he now reverses the deal and he wants to test God and say, well, God, this time let the dew fall all around the fleece and let the fleece be dry. Again, God Almighty graciously confirmed his power to Gideon. Our Lord was developing this man into a fully convinced servant of God, matching each doubt with kind assurance. God will show you and I the same favor, my friend. As long as we seek his face, as long as we put aside our fears and begin to trust in the word of Almighty God, God would work on our behalf. I believe tonight that as we go into 2021, there are many people putting out fleeces before the Lord because they want an answer from God. But I'm saying to you, God will develop you and make you into what he wants you to be. Make sure your life is right with God. Be obedient to his voice. Stay faithful to him. And he will prove himself to you. Finally, success is determined by God's power, not by our power. Amen. We see that from verse 1 of chapter 7. Gideon is now ready to do what God has called him to do. And verse 2 says, the Lord said to Gideon, you have too many people for me to hand the Midianites over to you. Or else you might brag, I did this by myself. So the Lord, continue now. And so many people are coming to help in this fight. And so the Lord is saying, now it's too many of you, Gideon. So God proceeds to give Gideon a couple tests to bring the number down. And so the first test removed 22,000 men from the figure. And now we just have 10,000. And still 10,000 was too many for God. The second test God gave him, he says, let them go down by the river, by the water, and let them begin to drink. And those who go right down with their mouth of the water, we don't want them involved in this battle. Just those who take up with their hand and put to their mouth, we're going to use them. And from that arrangement, 9,700 men were sent home. He was left with only 300. Can you imagine how Gideon felt? If you read further down in chapter 8, it will tell you that the army that they were going up against was 135,000 men strong. That was 450 Midianites to every Israelite. 300 men alone to fight 135,000. But you see, God created an impossible situation for human weakness to exalt their own strength. They couldn't do it on their own. And so in that situation, it brings to our mind those powerful words in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 18 and verse 27. What is impossible with men is possible with God. And that's a good lesson for us to remember tonight. Amen. God is God and He alone is God. And if He said He's going to do it with 300, just believe Him. He is going to fight for us. Amen. God will glorify Himself on earth through people who are fully dependent on Him. Through people who believe in Him and He alone. Through people who put their complete trust in Him for deliverance, God will come true for them. God does not need a majority vote. No, no. As one person said, me and Jesus, we are a majority. Praise God. When we invite Him into everything that we are doing, when we yield ourselves to Almighty God's will, we are going to reap the benefits and Almighty God will get the glory. Praise God. I remember the words of D.L. Moody. Give me 10 men who fear nothing but sin and love nothing but God, and I shall change the world. Praise God. I encourage you tonight. It happened in Israel. One of the strangest battle strategies. The 300 went out with trumpets and torches and jars. And the Bible says they went down to the camp of the Midianites. God set confusion in the midst of the ranks. And they started to fight each other. When it was over, 120,000 Midianites had been killed. And the other 15,000 fled. It was over. God had answered the prayers of the Midianites, but He used one common man who believed in God. One ordinary man. Praise God. As I conclude tonight, I want to let you know from these lessons that God uses tough times to get our attention. And as you look back at 2020, I want to ask you the question, has God gotten your attention? Has COVID-19 and this pandemic that's affecting the world, all the lockdowns and restrictions, millions of deaths, has it got your attention? God always sees more than we do because He sees what we cannot see. We cannot see what God knows in the future. Amen. God confirms His priorities with His presence. Can you sense His presence right now? Urging you to just keep trusting in God? Can you sense him saying to you, trust in me and in me alone? Private faithfulness is a prerequisite to public usefulness. You want God to use you in 2021? Be faithful to Almighty God. Are there things in your life, in your home, things that need to be removed, things that need to go so the power of God can move into your life, can move into your home? God is patient. It's a faith process, but he wants to meet you at the point of your need. Success is determined by God's power, not your power. I encourage you, trust God today. As we face 2021, trust God with your life. Trust God with your family. Trust God with your finances. Trust God with your decisions. 2021 might be uncertain to us, but I'm not worried. I'm trusting God. I'm assured that God will bring us through 2021. Shall we pray? Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, I give you praise and thanks for your word, dear God. You prove yourself time and time again to be Israel's deliverer. And just as you worked in the life of Gideon, I know you can work in our lives, dear God. Everyone listening, everyone viewing, dear God, you can work in our lives. Lord, for many, we might be uncertain concerning the events that are going to face us next year. But today, God, our trust is in you. We pray for mercy. We pray for forgiveness. We ask for your divine guidance. I pray for our viewers, dear God. I pray for our brethren tonight. That as this new year comes around, we are all going to ready ourselves, dear Father. We are going to make our lives right with you, God. We're going to get rid of everything that's going to hinder us. And we are going to stand with our complete trust and faith in you. You said to Gideon, I'm going to be with you. And tonight I know you are going to be with us in 2021, dear God. Whatever the enemy might have planned for us, dear God, whatever the future holds, I know you are going to be with us. I have assurance. We are going to keep trusting in you, dear God. Bless our viewers tonight as they surrender themselves to you, as they remove the idols, the things that are going to hinder them, and as they give you alone the praise, the honor, and the glory. Let our trust be renewed tonight, only in you, only in you, God. I give you praise, honor, and glory in Jesus' wonderful and precious name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. As the new year approaches in just a little while, on behalf of my family, my wife, and my children, I would like to say happy new year and God's richest blessing to you for 2021. I turn us over this time to Pastor Joseph Lauer. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
So, Lord, thank you, Pastor Lincoln. Truly, we thank God for that timely and encouraging word tonight. You know, Pastor Lincoln, you mentioned about predictions in before you started to preach. You may not have made a prediction, but I believe that we have a word for 2021. Praise the Lord. I truly do believe that with all of my heart, that we have a word that can take us into 2021. And even unto the end of 2021. Praise the Lord. We thank God for his servant tonight and the way that he has used him to minister to our hearts. As we continue tonight, we want to have a short time of prayer. And we want to pray in relation for the ministry that God is going to lead and direct and have his way in the year 2021. So right where you are at this time, I want you to just lift your hand together with me and just let's believe God tonight. Just come into agreement tonight as we call upon the Lord. Father, we just give you thanks. We give to you the praise and the honor and the glory. We thank you yet again for your word. We thank you yet again, Father, for keeping us through 2020, Father. We thank you, O God, for your many blessings upon our lives. Lord, as we look into 2021, Father God, we just commit every aspect of our lives into your hands, O God. Lord, we thank you, O God, that you continue to lead your people by your Spirit. And Father, we pray regarding the ministry tonight. Father, we pray firstly for the leadership, that God, you're going to continue to grant health and strength and wisdom, O God, to the bishops, dear Father, that you're going to continue to give them direction, O God, for the ministry, Father, that you're going to continue to meet and to supply every need in their lives, Father. God, the leadership of all the branch assemblies tonight, we lift them and their families into your hands. Let your divine covering, O God, remain upon your people. Father, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, continue to use the leadership, O God, in the different parts of the vineyard, O God, to strengthen and to God to win more souls for the kingdom. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, tonight in Jesus' name, we pray, Holy Father God, even as you were with Gideon, God, we are confident that you're going to be with us. So Father, we pray for your continued direction, Father, that everything that God we set out to do, that God, it will be accomplished, that God, we will have victory on every side in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Even, O God, in the times of darkness, I pray, Father, that your light will shine through this ministry, O God. That, Father, we will continue to be light and salt to this community in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God, take us into a new level. Take us into a higher level, O God, as a ministry tonight, Father. God, I pray in Jesus' name, oh God, just open our eyes to see, God, that which you are showing us tonight. That, Father, that we will, oh God, approach it with confidence, that we will move forward with confidence, oh God. We thank you, Father, for being with us. We thank you for your promise to always be with us, even to the end of the age. And so, Father, we commit, oh God, the ministry into your hands. And we say, Father God, move and have your way. Be glorified, oh God, through true worshipers, evangelistic center, dear Father, in 2021. May this ministry, oh God, continue to bring honor and glory to your name, Father. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I commit every member, every, oh God, believer, dear Father, of the ministry into your hands. Continue to bless and to prosper your people, Father. Continue to work within families, bringing restoration, bringing healing, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you tonight, God, for health and for strength and for your blessings, oh God, in 2021. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Bless the Lord. Bless his holy and majestic name. We thank God for a wonderful service thus far. And at this time, I want to welcome Pastor Kerry Maharaj, who would bring to us our announcements tonight. I want to welcome him at this time.
Good night and greetings in the holy and precious name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I want to say on behalf of my wife and my daughter and all of the saints of the Valencia Assembly a happy, happy new year, and God bless you all. Amen. So for the announcements, we want to remind you that Sunday morning we have our word and worship service, and it can be viewed online, and that's at 8 o'clock. All right, 8 o'clock. Those of you that are not going to any services on Sunday morning, join us on the live from 8 a.m. Then on Wednesday evening, it's a Bible study and prayer meeting, and that's via the Zoom. So all the members of TWC, just connect with your leaders. Amen. Thursday night, we have our Bible study and prayer meeting online. Amen. We're here again. It's a new year. It's the first Thursday in the year, so plan to be there. Amen. It starts at 8 p.m. sharp. And then we, in case you're wondering about the prayer meeting, we are going to have our week of prayer and fast. Amen. And this is going to be starting on January the 4th until the 8th. Amen. Every year we have a week of prayer and fast in the beginning of the new year. So remember, it's January the 4th to the 8th. Amen. And a very special announcement. And this is Pastor Elder Brethren of Scarborough New Testament Church, together with this Global Bible Marathon. They are having their Global Bible Marathon. Yes, and this is starting on the 1st of January to the 5th of January. It will be streamed live on Facebook and YouTube. Amen. And of course, we will try to make that link available to you guys. Amen. Zion Gate will be supporting on Saturday the 2nd and Sunday the 3rd. And also we have some folks from TWEC joining them. Amen. So God bless you. God bless you. And have a happy, happy new year.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor Kerry. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Well, we have come to the end of our service tonight, and I trust that you have been blessed, and you have been strengthened, and you have been made ready to approach 2021 with the zeal, with the positivity and the confidence that you need to. So we thank God for all that was said and done tonight. And we say a special thank you to all our viewers tonight and all our TWEC brethren and all the assemblies. God bless you tonight. Thank you for taking the time to join us. And truly, from my family to yours, I wish you a happy new year, a blessed and prosperous 2021. As we dismiss in prayer this time, could you just bow your heads with me? Father, we thank you for the wonderful service tonight. We thank you for this wonderful and awesome presence, O God, that was in our midst tonight, Father. We thank you for your wonderful presence. We thank you for speaking to our hearts, O God, and for speaking so clearly tonight, Father. We give you the praise and the glory. Father God, continue to have your way in each and every one of our lives. We thank you, O God, yet again, for bringing us through 2020 into 2021. Continue to have your way in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen. Bless the Lord. We, at this time, I just want to welcome back Brother Stefan and family, who's going to take us out into a time of worship. Happy New Year to you all. God bless you and good night. Hallelujah. Oh.
One more time. I will not be silent.
And I will not be silent. I will always I will not be silent. I will always worship you.
Well, I said, no, receive my worship, all of my worship, receive my, all of my worship, receive my worship, all of my worship, yeah, receive my worship, all of my worship, you Lord. You and no one can worship you for me, for all the things that you have done for me. You see, no one can worship you for me. So, Lord.
And I will not be silent.
All of my worship.
Receive all worship.